Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial. My name is John and today we're gonna learn how to upload and share your video on YouTube. If you haven't watched it yet, we also have a tutorial on how to edit a video for YouTube in Canva. Canva, as you probably know, is a free online tool that allows you to edit videos easily. So if you haven't watched that, we recommend watching it first before looking at this video. Today I'm going to show you how to upload your video, how to make it public as well, how to upload thumbnails for the video, and how to edit subtitles, auto subtitles, which means YouTube generates subtitles automatically for this kind of videos. I won't go in depth into editing subtitles because that's a whole different job in itself, and it involves somebody actually doing the translation interpretation of the speech. But I will refer to the function of auto translation that's available here on YouTube. So to get started, you need your video first of all. So I'm in my YouTube channel here. So it's the Rural Tour YouTube channel where we have the videos uploaded for this project. So let's use the video we edited previously in Canva and upload it here and show you what you need to do, what information you need to fill, and everything that's required. So first of all, you go onto YouTube, you go to YouTube Studio here on your channel, you click create and select upload videos, and from here you select your file, the video file that you want to upload. You can also drag and drop it. I'm gonna do just that, so I have my video here. It's Madisol's Mount Errigal hike, a video about Madisol's, which is an adventure website based in Ireland. So I'm gonna drag this file over here, and as you can see, YouTube already is starting to upload it. It's uploading very fast because it's a very short video. The title here, as an example, because we're on the Rural Tour channel, I'm gonna write Rural Tour Project Muddy Souls. Adventure guide. All right, so our video is almost uploaded. As you can see here, now YouTube is checking it. During this checkup, actually YouTube verifies the music. If you're using copyrighted music, sometimes you might have the issue of your video being taken down, which we don't recommend actually, but sometimes YouTube allows you to keep your video up, but you won't be able to monetize it. As you can see here, because we have a popular track on the video, it's called Days Like This by Dermot Kennedy, we have an exclamation mark which says that our video is copyrighted, but the owner allows the content to be used on YouTube, so we don't have any issues. All right, so over here, I've added my title and I'm gonna add the description as well. It's important to add description to this section because you can talk about your video, you can give more details, you can also put timestamps on the video. So I'm gonna show you here, I have my description already. So I'm gonna copy paste it. Okay, so as you can see, it's a short description of Madisol's. Madisol's website, Facebook and Instagram handles, social media. And now I want to add more info about my project as well. So about Rural Tour, I'm gonna copy this as well. So this is a description for the Rural Tour project together with a website and social media information, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So I'm gonna add my hashtags as well for this video. Erasmus Plus, Muddy Souls, Rural Tourism, Ireland. All right, so I'm gonna have this in. As you can see, YouTube already generated a couple of thumbnails. I can choose whichever I want, including this one. which is the title one. Sometimes it happens that YouTube does not generate the thumbnail for your intro, so you might need to actually do that manually. You simply open your video and you do a screenshot, and then you crop the image to fit for the thumbnail. You can also upload your custom thumbnail. To create a custom thumbnail, you can use Canva, the tool that we already talked about. Just go to canva.com, and here in the search bar you can go to, you can search for YouTube thumbnail, and over here you'll see all these templates, and you can pick whichever you think fits your project, or you can go for a blank one. And over here, you drag your images. So it's very easy to create a thumbnail. You go to your images and you pick whichever image you want, and you add a text to it. I won't go in detail right now because we already covered adding images and text. So if you want to learn more about it, please check out the previous tutorial about video editing in Canva. So this is a custom thumbnail. If I want to use a custom thumbnail, I can upload my own, like this one here. So basically this is it. The checks are complete. Our video is good to go. You can select if it's made for kids or not. I recommend clicking no, it's not made for kids. We also have some more settings down here. So we have more information here. For this kind of videos, we recommend adding the language to English, or the language that your video was shot in, to allow for caption, closed captions. Closed captions or subtitles are generated automatically here on YouTube, and I'm going to show you how it works. But first, let's go ahead and publish our video. To do that, we click on next. And then next again, and on this screen here we have the option to select one of the following: public, unlisted, or private. If we click on private, the video won't be available to anyone except us when we log into our channel. So yes, this is a private option if you want to keep your videos to yourself. If we select unlisted, this means that the video is available only to the person who has a link to this specific video. So anyone with the video link can watch the video on YouTube. It's not listed. If anyone goes to your channel and views the list of videos, they won't be able to see this one because it will be unlisted. And public, it means that everyone can watch it and find your video publicly on YouTube. Obviously, we recommend going for public, and you hit on publish. So your video is up. This is your link. You can copy your link and share it. To view it, just click on it.
It's not always raining, there'll be days like this. When there's no one complaining, there'll be days like this. When everything falls into place like the flick of a switch. Well, my mama told me there'll be days like this.
All right, so our video is up. We have the description here, everything, as you can see, that we added. We can edit this at any time we want. If there's something that we missed or there's something that we want to add, we simply go back to our channel here and we click on details, and we have the option to modify anything around here. Alright, so if we want to add subtitles to our videos, there are a couple of things that we can do. If the video is in a language that's supported by YouTube, like English or Spanish or Italian, we can upload the video, we can select the language, and YouTube can auto-generate subtitles. The issue with this kind of captioning is that they're automatic, which means they're generated by machine learning algorithms, so the quality of the subtitles may vary. YouTube encourages creators to add professional captions first. So that means having somebody creating the subtitles manually interpreting the words and synchronizing everything in a third-party software. That can be a bit of advanced for some users, actually editing subtitles in a third-party software. So we won't go into that at the moment, but we recommend working with professional subtitles anytime you have the opportunity to do so. But in this case, if we want to add subtitles automatically and also have the option to edit them, here is what we can do. To give you an example, I'm going to take a video from our project here, a video that's in English. I'm going to go for, I'm going to go for this video here. When you click on edit settings on the details here, you have the option to insert subtitles. So if you click on subtitles, you can see that YouTube already generated this kind of subtitles for my video. The problem is that they're not very accurate sometimes, so I need to go and edit them. And you can do that very easily by actually going through the text. And as you can see here, let's say Wild Atlantic Way here, so I don't like this one. It's Atlantic Way. And you can easily edit this. You can see here and on the screen that the text is being updated. So you can look for mistakes, you can look for spelling mistakes, obviously, and you can edit those out. And the moment you have everything done, you click on done and the subtitle is available. If you click on the video, to turn on subtitles, you simply go and click on CC here.
Hi there, my name is Irvin Kearns and I'm co-director of Crusader Cabins. Our company offers unique accommodation located along the Wild Atlantic Way. I'm going to show you Sea View Captain on the road.
And we have another error there, Sea View Captain, Sea View Cabin. So we can go and edit that. You can see that, you know, sometimes YouTube gets it wrong, so that's why it's important to update your subtitles. If you want to translate the subtitles, you turn them on, and then you go here, you go to subtitles, you go to auto translate, and you select whichever language you like. I don't know, let's say French.
Are you Sea View Cabin? So we are here at Sea View Cabin. We set up Sea View Cabin back in 2017 to complement an original business of ours that was set up 4x4 blindfold driving.
So yes, you can auto-generate subtitles easily. So you can do this for any type of video content that has spoken word, obviously. So this being said, today we learned how to upload video on YouTube, how to edit the thumbnail, and also how to add our description here, along with the social media handles and everything. And I think that's it. We will also have some more information on how to do some advanced editing. We will link to some tutorials, online tutorials, if you want to go deeper into that, if you want to learn how to edit video in a more professional software. We will also link some information and knowledge on how to share your video on YouTube and how to edit thumbnails as well. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is John, and see you next time.